tiene la alabanza y ahí la solo tiene que hacerlo. Sí, vamos.
Señor, le bendiga, hermanos.
Le damos la bienvenida
a todos los que estamos acá. Dándole gracias al Señor que nos dio regalo un día más.
So de vida. We want to thank the Lord for one day that he one more day that he gave us.
Le damos gracias al Señor que estamos en la casa de él dándole las gracias a él y sabemos de que pues permanecemos ahí tambaleando pero estamos aquí de frente.
And we thank God to have us here. Maybe we may not be doing well, but here we are to worship him.
Glorificándole al Señor
to glorify his name.
Y bueno, bienvenidos.
So welcome.
Voy a estar leyendo el Salmo 6.
I'll be reading in Psalms 6.
De dos al 6.
From 2 to 6.
Y dice, Jehová me...
Jehová, no me reprendas.
Jehová, no me reprendas en tu enojo.
Ajá, sí. Ni me castigues.
Ni me castigues con tu ira. Ten misericordia de mí, oh Jehová, porque estoy enfermo.
Amén.
Sáname, oh Jehová, porque mis huesos se estremecen. Mi alma también está muy turbada. Uh-huh. Y tú, Jehová, estás...
¿Hasta cuándo?
¿Hasta cuándo?
Vuélvete.
Oh Jehová, líbrame de mí.
Libra mi alma,
sálvame por tu misericordia, porque en la muerte no hay memoria
de ti.
En el Seol, ¿quién te alabará?
Me he consumido
a fuerza de
mi gemido.
Oremos.
Termina ahí donde dice: todas las noches inundo de llanto mi lecho, riego mi cama con mis lágrimas. Lo voy a leer en inglés y después oramos. It says, O Lord, rebuke me not in thy anger, neither chasten me in thy hot displeasure. Have mercy upon me, O Lord, for I am weak. O Lord, heal me, for my bones are vexed. My soul is also sore vexed, but thou, O Lord, how long? Return, O Lord, deliver me, my soul. O save me for my mercy's sake. For in death there is no remembrance of thee. In the grave who shall give thee thanks? I am weary with my groaning all night. Make I my bed to swim. I water my couch with tears.
Bueno, creo que todos estamos preparados para oír las alabanzas.
I believe that everyone here is ready to
para recibir el pan que el Señor nos tiene preparado este día.
To worship and to receive the bread of life that the Lord has for us.
Y me sorprendió el pastor esta mañana.
And the pastor surprised me this morning.
Pero me acordé de la hermana Zayda el domingo antepasado que ella dijo de que tenemos que ser obedientes.
But I remember that last Sunday when Zayda did preach about being obedient.
A veces no tenemos que obedecer al hombre.
Sometimes we do not obey to men.
Ni obedecer a nadie.
And maybe not nobody else
en esta tierra,
in this earth.
Pero hay uno que es el supremo.
But there is one that he is the high, supreme.
Que es el que nos manda a obedecer.
He is the one that commanded us to obey.
Porque yo creo de que si nosotros fuéramos como las ovejas, que no tenemos quien nos mande.
Because I believe if we were like sheep with no pastor.
Corremos para cada pradera donde no hay detenimiento.
And then we will be running on the fields with no direction.
A veces, aunque no querramos estar bien,
sometimes,
el Señor sabe cómo nosotros nos encontramos.
We don't want to feel sick, but the Lord knows how we feel sometimes.
Pero en esta tarde yo les estoy mencionando esto porque.
But in this hour, I'm just mentioning this because.
Yo le tengo mucho temor a Dios.
I fear the Lord.
Yes, aleluya.
Para, yo creo de que, no sé. Si yo cometo alguna cosa que tal vez por mínima que sea, creo que yo tengo que pedirle perdón a Dios.
I believe that even if I do something small to displease God, I still need to ask Him to forgive me.
Entonces, yo creo de que tengo tantas cosas, pero es mejor que a veces, como decimos en nuestro pensar, que es mejor calladito es más bonito, ¿verdad?
And sometimes in a quiet measure.
Pero en las cosas de Dios, si yo me siento de que necesito a Dios en mi corazón.
So I believe that I, in my life, I need God in my heart.
Y necesito estar en el templo porque yo sé de que con las alabanzas, el mensaje, yo me lleno.
I believe that I need to be to congregate because through the worship and praise and through the word of God.
Y es que a veces amanezco que me duele hasta el pelo, pero aquí estoy.
I'm filled with the word of God and the worship and praise, but I'm here today.
Por la gracia del Señor, cerramos nuestros ojos, vamos a orar pidiéndole al Creador de que nos dé la sabiduría para.
By the grace of God, we are here. Let us close our eyes and let us pray.
Poderoso Dios, venimos delante de tu presencia.
Mighty God, we come here before your presence.
Dándote la gracia, Señor, a ti.
Giving you thanks.
Porque tú eres bueno, porque tú eres fiel.
Because you're great and you're faithful.
Porque sin ti, Señor, no somos nadie sobre esta tierra.
Because without you, we are nobody in this earth.
Te ruego, te pido que las alabanzas y el que trae el mensaje, que seas tú, Señor, hablando por ellos.
Father God, I ask you to use the worship and praise and also the messenger today.
Y que se quede en nuestro corazón y en nuestras mentes.
And that everything will stay in our minds and our hearts.
Y que podamos meditar, Señor, en ti.
And that we can meditate in you.
Que podamos ser, Señor, como tú dijiste, esas ovejas de tu prado.
Father God, we want to be like the sheep of your pastures.
Que seamos obedientes a ti, Señor.
That we will be obedient to you, Lord.
Porque tú, Señor, estás con nosotros cada día, cada segundo.
You are with us every day in this world.
Te ruego, Señor, que apures todos los que vienen en camino, Señor.
I ask you, Father, to hurry those that are still on their way.
Que los guardes, que los proteja y que lleguen con bien a tu santo templo.
So you can protect them so they can arrive safe to the temple.
Gracias, Señor, por todo lo que nos has dado este día y por lo que vamos a recibir.
And I thank you, Father God, for what you have given to us and for what we are about to receive.
En el poderoso nombre de nuestro Señor Jesucristo, te pido gracias, Señor.
In the mighty name of Jesus, I thank you.
En el nombre de Jesús, amén.
In the name of Jesus, amen.
Amen. Aleluya. Gracias.
Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God, my Lord. Él es Jehová, aleluya. Dios de la creación. Yes, God of creation, aleluya. Jehovah is his name, aleluya. Dios de la creación. Es Jehová, Dios poderoso, el Dios de la creación,
es Jehová,
Dios que está creando. Mr. Narrow,
Hallelujah.
Sí, Señor. Aleluya. Sí, Señor.
Hallelujah, thank you, God. Awesome, Jesus.
May God bless you.
Gracias a Dios, verdad, porque Él es bueno.
We thank God because He is awesome.
Estamos acá en este lugar es por la misericordia.
If we are here in this place, is because of the mercy of God.
Yes.
We are more than blessed.
Yes.
We know that He gives us everything.
Yes.
And at this hour is the time for tithe and offerings. And where we had the opportunity to give a small portion of the big portion that He gave us. If we give, it's not because out of necessity. We give because He already gave us. Because He had blessed us already. We are healthy. We have a job. We have a family. And I can say that we are more than blessed.
Yes.
Let us pray for a tithe and offering. Heavenly Father, I thank you first because I know that you're good. Thank you for your mercy, for your love that you have for all of us. That even without deserving me, you are there every day with us, blessing us, giving us good health, giving us the strength that we need in order to do our jobs. And at this hour, God, I give you thanks for every brother and sister here that had a purpose in their heart to bring a portion of the big portion that you have given. I ask you for a special blessing in their jobs and everything that they purpose in their hearts and their life. Please do not depart from us. I ask you, Father God, to also bless those that cannot give, because you know every situation. And we ask you as well that they will be blessed, that you will protect them, that you will keep them safe with your mighty hand. Thank you for everything.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes, this is the day that the Lord has made.
Oh,
Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Heavenly Father.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Glory to your name.
Thank you, Jesus.
My God.
So, as we wait on the speaker this morning, I would just like you all to know that we're going to have a special treat today.
Amen.
Amen. We have, you ready for this? Pastora. Right? Pastora. Husband and wife shall become one, right? That's the Bible. You cannot separate them. Pastor, Pastora, is going to be giving a sermon this morning from the Lord.
Amen.
And quite a few of us have requested it because we were not here when she gave the last message. So we were like, we really want her to give us this message from the Lord.
Amen.
So this morning, if you'll please raise your hand real quick. We're going to pray a blessing over her so that the Holy Spirit will work through her directly to our hearts. Hallelujah. So, hallelujah. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Lord God, in Jesus' name, Lord God. In Jesus' name, Lord. I ask for a special anointing, Lord God. An anointing that will break the yoke this morning, Lord God. That all of our problems will be forgotten, for we have heard from you, Lord God. And that's what we come to your throne for, Lord God, is to hear your words, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Lord God, use her this morning, Lord God, in a special way, Lord God. Heavenly Father, I ask in Jesus' name, Lord God, surround her about, Lord God. And we bind up any kind of evil that try to come against her, Lord God. She speaks this message this morning, Lord God. Lord God, we love you, we praise you, and we thank you for her, Father.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to your name, Jesus.
God bless you, everyone.
Thank you.
I
don't get on with it,
huh? I hope I do. My message. So, because we're living, so I was asked to preach.
Hallelujah.
And I like what Sister Marta stated to last Sunday. Because that's what it's all about, being obedient. So we believe it doesn't do good to come to the temple and to just listen to a message, but we forget. We might not put to practice what we preach. The Word of God says that we need to be obedient to our authorities. If we can be obedient to the president of this nation, to the police, with more written obedient to God. Because he gave his only son so he could die for on our behalf.
Yes.
It is so good.
Yes.
And it's very important.
Yes.
That every word that is preached in this place,
yes,
it is to put it to work, to practice it. So, let us go forward.
So,
last Sunday I was preaching about obedience, and I was talking about 1 Samuel 15. Second, if you can go to the other side of the camera. So the king Saul, we knew that he was disobedient. So because we need to obey God, and just only one thing. But there are other things we don't. So, and I was saying that to be obedient to God is 100%. There's no 20% or 50%. Be obedient to God 100%.
Hallelujah.
You cannot be over the authority if you have not learned to be obedient. Nobody can become a leader if you did not put to practice being obedient. Because you will not have authority when you speak because you were not obedient.
Por eso Dios pone pastores.
That's why the Lord appoints pastors, leaders, that they will be in leadership in the group so we can be obedient to them.
Ese es el deseo de Dios.
That is the desire of God.
Tenemos que obedecer
so
a nuestros líderes.
We need to obey our leaders.
Si realmente amamos a Dios.
If we really love God.
Y si realmente amamos a nuestro
if
prójimo.
We really love our neighbors.
Porque también les dije que la gran comisión, como
because
ustedes ya saben,
it is also, I was talking about the Great Commission.
La gran comisión es que salgamos todos a predicar la palabra de Dios.
The Great Commission that we should all go out and preach.
Porque allá afuera hay muchos que todavía.
Because out there, there are many that still not in.
No quieren saber nada de Dios.
And many don't want to know about God.
Para eso estamos.
And that's why we're here.
Amen.
In regardless if you're a child, if it's a woman. And I know that many do not agree about a woman preacher. But I also told you that if we as women don't do it, the
wolves
will speak. But the word of God will doesn't have to stop.
No se debe de
it won't stop.
También les dije que tenemos que obedecer a Dios de buena gana.
And I also told you that we need to obey God with a good attitude.
De buena voluntad.
With a good will.
Es algo que uno escoge.
It is something that,
por amor a Dios.
That we choose to do for the love
porque,
of God.
Porque hermanos, si nosotros no hemos llegado a comprender.
Because if we have not understand.
La magnitud del sacrificio de Dios.
The magnitude of the sacrifice
Jesús,
of God.
De la cruz del Calvario.
Of Jesus on Calvary.
Mal.
And then I believe we are
no
not okay. I believe we are not, have not understood
el hecho de que Jesús murió
because
por nosotros,
the only act that Jesus died for us
it
is enough reason for us to be obedient.
¿Por qué somos tan desobedientes?
But why we are so disobedient?
Yo voy a estar leyendo en primero de Juan 2:3-6.
I will be reading in 1 John 2:3-6.
Primera de Juan 3:6 dice.
First John 2:3-6 says.
Y en esto sabemos que nosotros le conocemos si guardamos sus mandamientos.
And here we do know that we know him if we keep his commandments.
El que dice, yo le conozco y no guarda sus mandamientos, el tal es mentiroso y la verdad no está en él.
He that says, I know him and keepeth not his commandments, it is a liar. And the truth is not in him.
Pero el que guarda su palabra, en este verdaderamente el amor de Dios se ha perfeccionado. Por esto sabemos que estamos en él.
But those who keep his word, in him verily is the love of God.
Perfect. El que dice que permanece en él, debe andar como él anduvo.
And that is said that the Bible is in him, ought to himself also to walk even as he walked.
¿Alguna vez
have you asked yourself sometimes why we are not obedient? If you can make your own analysis and you may be able to answer that question. Maybe it is because we feel that we are self-sufficient. It may be because the natural, the wicked that is in our natures. Or is it because it is harder for us to understand that we are not okay? When we were children, and our mothers would tell us to do something.
Dígame si es mentira o verdadero.
And tell me otherwise.
Que casi siempre preguntamos, ¿y yo por qué yo?
That if every time we will respond, why me? And why me?
¿Y por qué me mandas a mí?
And why I have to do
it? Porque siempre estamos argumentando, como les decía la pasada.
As I was saying, why we always have to argue?
Dios ya no quiere sacrificios.
God doesn't expect for us sacrifices.
Quiere obediencia.
He wants us to be obedient.
De nada sirve.
It doesn't do good
que dejemos de hacer algunas cosas,
that if we stop doing some things,
si eres desobediente en otras,
if we disobey in other things.
La obediencia debe ser continua.
The, being obedient means that something that we do
cada
continuously,
día.
Every day.
Y es un largo camino, hermano, porque no es fácil ser obediente.
And I know it's tough, it's not easy to be obedient.
Por eso nosotros debemos orar a Dios.
And that's why we need to pray to God to help us to be obedient.
Solo con la ayuda de Dios nosotros podemos ser obedientes.
Only with the help of God we will be able to do that.
Les voy a hacer otra pregunta, pero ustedes la responden ustedes mismos.
I will ask you a rhetorical question that you can, may answer yourself.
Cuando usted ora,
when you pray,
¿alguna vez ha pedido a Dios, Señor, ayúdame a ser obediente?
Have you asked God to help you to be obedient?
Ayúdame a obedecerte.
Help me to obey you.
Ayúdame a hacer tu voluntad.
Help me to do your will.
Yes. ¿Lo hemos hecho?
Have you done it? Have we done it?
¿O solo pedimos por salud?
Or is it that sometimes we just ask for help?
Por las finanzas.
For our finances.
Por un trabajo.
For a job.
¿Alguna vez lo hemos preguntado?
Have we done that?
Debemos pedirle ayuda
we
a Dios.
We need to ask God for help.
Porque sin él,
because without
no
God,
hacer,
we can't do it.
Amen.
Amen.
Como ustedes todos saben, as la primera persona que desobedeció,
all know that the first person that was disobedient
a Dios fue Eva.
To God was Eve.
Y luego fue Adán.
And then her husband, Adam.
¿Qué fue lo primerito que hizo Adán y Eva?
What was the first thing that they did after that they ate the fruit, the forbidden fruit?
Se escondieron, ¿verdad?
They hid.
Yes.
Se escondieron porque les dio vergüenza.
They hid because they were ashamed.
Porque cuando abrieron sus ojos.
Because when their eyes were open.
Al comer el fruto.
When they ate the fruit.
Fueron abiertos sus ojos.
Their eyes were open.
Y vieron que estaban desnudos.
And they saw that they were naked.
Y quisieron esconderse de la presencia de Dios.
And they wanted to hide from the presence of God.
¿Acaso quién puede creer que se puede esconder de la presencia de Dios?
So, is there someone that believes that they can hide from the presence of God?
Nadie.
Nobody.
No.
Nobody.
Mira Jonás dónde terminó.
So see Jonah, where he ended up.
Jonás prefirió gastar en un boleto.
So he preferred to spend some money and buy a ticket.
Porque según él.
To go somewhere else.
Iba a huir de la presencia de Dios.
According to him, he thought that he was going to flee from the presence of God.
Por eso le fue como le fue.
And that's why he ended up doing what he did.
In
Proverbs 28:1, it says that the wicked will flee without nobody persecuting him. And the righteous person is trusting God like a lion.
¿Por qué cada vez que nosotros pecamos, hermanos, y me incluyo?
And why do you think that every time that we commit a sin, and I'm included there, why do you think that we hide?
¿Por qué corremos?
Why we run away?
¿Por qué andamos avergonzados?
Because we are, why we're walking ashamed.
Porque el pecado trae eso, vergüenza.
Because that's what sin brings.
Pero es cuando más debemos de buscar de Dios.
And there we, that moment is there where we should look more for God.
Muchos han dejado de asistir a los templos.
Many have stopped congregating.
Porque posiblemente se creen muy sucios y muy indignos.
Because they believe that they have sinned so much.
Se les olvida que Dios es un Dios de amor.
And they forget that God is a God of love and God of mercy. And that His mercies are new every day.
Yes, every day.
That if we commit a sin, we have an advocate that will defend us.
God
will not reject someone with a humble heart. Never. That's why when we sin, we have to run to the house of God. We need to ask God to forgive us. We don't have to confess to another man. We can go directly to our Heavenly Father. And that we will humble before His presence. We ask Him to forgive us. And then He is always with His open arms to love us, to forgive us. Amen. We will never flee from the presence of God. Because He's omniscient. He's omnipresent. He sees everything. He knows everything. He is everywhere at the same time. So even regardless of if we try to hide, we will not hide from God. Psalm 139:7 says, it says, where should I go from the presence of God? And where should I flee from the presence of God? Many know the true obedience. God will prepare a great future for us. When we congregate, beloved,
aquí estamos siendo entrenados.
So we are here being trained.
Voy con las personas que no están de acuerdo con congregarse.
That's why there are people that do not agree about how important it is to congregate.
Una persona que dice, no,
a person that may say, well, I have my own altar at my house. I make my own devotional at home.
Tenga mucho cuidado.
So be careful on that.
Porque aquí es que estamos siendo probados.
Because here is where we are tried.
Si usted no quiere venir a la iglesia porque hay hipócritas.
If you don't want to come to church because many hypocrites there.
Porque hay malos hermanos.
Because there are some bad brothers.
Por el motivo que sea.
Or whatever the reason that you may have.
Ninguna razón va a valer ante los ojos de Dios.
There won't be no reason before the presence of God.
Cuando él traiga juicio.
When he brings us to judgment.
Nadie va a decir, no, yo no voy a la iglesia.
Nobody.
Yo iba a la iglesia.
Will say to Jesus, well, I was not going to church
ahí todos son unos
because everyone there were hypocrites. We've been here tried and trained at
y
the
si
same time.
No la
if
aquí,
we do not pass the test,
nadie
here,
va para
nobody is going to go up there. No one will be passing. If we do not go to trial here, here is where our tribe, our character is tried. But those who have short temper work in different places because in our jobs, we're tried in our character. And you know that you're going to meet people that are not a good attitude. That they have bad attitude.
They will always
meet people that are not of good character. And for that reason, we need to be here together.
Because
here is where we're going to hear a word for you and for me. So we can to learn how to lead.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
And on our daily lives. But if you stay at home, for whatever reason you may have, and at the first moment that you put your step outside your home, Satan will try to get a hold of you. He's going to try you. And you may fall because you are not ready. Because you are not ready.
Pero como usted quiere hacer,
but because if you want to make your own devotional own,
no está mal,
which I'm not saying that is that is not good to do,
bueno,
it's important to do that, to pray every day, to read the Word of God every day, but it's also we need to congregate.
Hallelujah.
That's why I thank God for each of you that are here.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Because here in this place it's cold.
No es fácil.
And it's not easy.
Pero como nosotros somos obedientes,
but because we are obedient.
That's right.
So here we are.
Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah. All of us,
we should have the same opportunity to leave a legacy. If you want to be remembered for the good things that you've done, or for the bad things that you have done. You can leave your own legacy. We can make the difference.
We
can leave a legacy to our children and to our grandchildren. And how would you like them to remember you? That my grandma, that they would say my grandma was a prayer warrior. My mother was a brave and courageous woman. How do we remember Abraham? As the father of faith. How we remember Moses? As the one, the liberator. How we remember Joseph? To the one that defeated temptation. Etc. Etc. So each one of us, we have the same opportunity. That's why even in the least thing, you can help us here. When we listen, for example, like when we finish service, do not just get your wallet in your purse and leave. Unless you have to go to work. There are little things that we need to put away. There are things that we can do together. That is to be obedient.
Yes.
Amen. We start from the little things. So we all that we have a job,
como mi esposo, por ejemplo,
as my husband, let's say,
él no estuvo en ese primer trabajo.
he didn't have that job that he has right now. He had to shovel snow.
So
he had to work for 12 hours, been sick with a fever, and been sick.
So
when we used to come to church, we would go and clean the bathrooms and help out. And even with the little things. So when we are faithful in the little things, God will exalt us. And again, the big question. Why is it so hard for us to obey? Last time I say because I mentioned that we were because we're selfish. Because our ego, because we think only about ourselves. And me, me. I want you. Everything is just about me. But we do not think about the souls. The lost souls. We do not care. We do not care for them. And God will ask us to give an account.
And
let us continue going forward. Let us preach the word to every creature. And you know another reason why we are not obedient? Because we don't like rules. We don't like regulations. We don't like to take responsibilities. Because we don't want to be committed. We just want things lightly. That we will be served. It is good when people serve us. But remember that Jesus did not come for him to be served. But he is the best teacher ever. He came to serve. Not to be served. So we ought to be like him. As it says in 1 John there. We should be more like Jesus every day. That we can follow his steps, his examples. And that's why, beloved, I invite you, I exhort you, I encourage you. That it is okay that we congregate. But we need to be obedient. Last time I also mentioned
that
not everyone only because it's in church will be saved. That's what the word of God says. Not all of those that call me Lord, Lord will enter to the kingdom of heaven. But that's his will. That's what the Lord says. I'm not saying it. The churches and the temples may be filled with people. Maybe the people are very empty inside. They may not have the love for the neighbors. They have no fear of God. Maybe they will have no love for nobody. And that's why it's very important to pay attention. That not only the flesh will be sitting there, but also your mind and your heart will be focused as well. And attention to what the preacher is saying. And that's why sometimes we forget it. Because we come to the temple and we just... we are here and then we start the conversations on the things that we can have over the phone. We need to remember what the word of God says, that faith comes from hearing and to hear the word of God. But it's not the same to hear than to listen. Because you can be sitting there,
but
you can hear because you have a good ears.
But
you're not listening. Because to listen will bring an action. And when we listen, your brain will go to a process. And that is where you put the word to work and to start doing the will of God. That's why, beloved. It is good to hear, but it's better to listen. Amen.
Obedecer a Dios es la mayor salvaguardia.
To obey God is the best thing to do.
Para vivir bien.
In order to live well.
Ser feliz.
To be happy.
Y hacer realidad.
And to do something to become real.
Las promesas que el Señor nos ha dado.
So the promise of God will be real in our lives.
Para obedecer no es necesario más que obedecer.
And to obey, what the only thing that we need is to obey.
No tiene nada más que hacer.
There's nothing else that we
solo
need to do.
Obedecer.
Just do it. Just obey.
Cuando te pongas a orar, acuérdate de pedirle a Dios.
When you pray, remember to ask God.
Que te ayude a ser sabio para obedecer.
That He will help you to be wise.
Sin duda
to
que
obey.
Dios te oye en lo secreto.
So between you and God in the secret moment,
te ayudará en tu petición.
He will give you the petition.
Cumpliendo así todos los propósitos.
Fulfilling that way all the purposes.
Y todas las promesas.
And all the promises.
That
you will have a pleasant life.
Que tu vida sea feliz.
That you will be a happy. That you will have a happy life.
Y que todas las cosas que te ha prometido.
And the other things that He has promised.
Que haga realidad en tu
will
vida.
Become real in your life.
Yes. Así que, hermano,
so beloved.
Me animo y les animo.
I encourage you and I encourage myself too.
A que sigamos adelante.
That let us keep walking this walk.
Dios nos ama.
God loves us.
Yes. Aleluya.
But there is another detail.
El domingo pasado también yo les decía.
Last Sunday I remember that I said.
Si su pareja es débil.
So if your husband or your partner is weak.
Si su esposo no está bien firme.
If your husband is not straightforward in the things of God.
Pero usted sí.
But if you are,
usted tiene que animarlo a él.
You need to encourage him.
Tiene que darle el ejemplo a él.
You need to be an example for him.
Yes.
And that's what
even
Reverend Mel mentioned it the last Sunday.
Los dos ayudan.
So the two will help each other.
Si es la mujer la que
anda
débil,
if it's the woman that is not walking straight,
o viceversa,
or vice versa,
los dos deben ayudarse,
so they should help each other because both are a complement.
Yes. Aleluya.
But only because the man is not doing the
no
right thing,
decir que la mujer igual.
It doesn't mean that the woman will also do the same.
Dos son mejor que uno.
So the Bible said that two are better than one.
Para eso Dios nos puso,
that's why we put us together, a man
para
and a woman, so we can help one another.
Yes.
Si alguno de ellos,
so if one of the two
anda mal,
is not right,
por ejemplo, lo voy a poner a mí de ejemplo.
An example myself.
A veces yo me quiero salir del.
Sometimes I want to like go this direction.
A veces me quiero poner un poco rebelde.
And sometimes I want
pero
to be a little rebel.
Pero gracias
a rebellious, and then thank God for my husband. That he will pull my ears.
Yeah.
It's true. And she said it's uncomfortable to be rebuked because of the flesh. But I thank God because of him. Because one of the things that I have accomplished as an example is to be able to drive and to become a UC citizen without speaking English well. And why? Because he encouraged me. To the point that I got frustrated and I say, I'm leaving back to Honduras. Because I almost got in an accident. I was so scared that I said, here are the keys. I don't want to know anything about driving. And my son David, my younger son, was in the vehicle. I don't know how I stopped the vehicle. Because instead of going forward, yeah, she went on reverse instead of going forward. And she didn't know how to find the brake.
So she said,
I thank God because I don't remember what I did. But after my husband was calmed down, after being scared, he said, don't worry. We all go through that one time. So what would have happened if I would give up? I would learn to drive.
Es muy regañón.
So he is like, he likes to...
Y me molestaba. Pero gracias a Dios.
But he was just pushy.
Aquel insistió.
And thank God, because he insisted.
Gracias a Dios y a él.
And I thank God to my husband.
Aprendí a manejar.
I learned to drive. And also, I passed the test to become a U.S. citizen.
Por eso, dos.
That's why two are better than one.
Yes, hallelujah.
Do not be afraid.
No.
To your husband or to your wife.
O a su esposo,
or to your husband.
Si anda pando.
If he is not walking straight, just exhort him, encourage him. But do not leave him alone.
Porque no. Eso va a caer sobre usted.
Because if you let him be, you're going to be responsible.
Del sacerdote Eli, ¿verdad?
You can remember an example of the priest Eli.
Eli. Sus hijos andaban mal.
His children were not walking
y él
right.
No le decía
and
nada.
He did not stumble
no,
on them. And remember
them.
And see how you pues, remember how they died. How they died.
Que lo que su esposa, su esposo
so
haga,
whatever your husband is doing or your wife, that's why we're there. So whatever it is, if it's good or bad, we're there to encourage one another. So because the sin will not be on you. May God bless you.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Obediencia es muy importante.
So that was the message for us today.
Es el mensaje de esta hora.
Better the second time around. Oh, boy. So what does that tell us?
¿Qué es lo que nos está diciendo esto?
It tells us we need to start trusting God.
Lo que nos dice es que comencemos a confiar en Dios.
And we need to start doing what God told us.
Y tenemos que comenzar a hacer lo que Dios nos ha dicho que hagamos. Porque el tiempo es corto.
Real short.
Bien corto.
Well, hallelujah to this morning. You please stand.
Sí, por favor, nos ponemos de pie en esta hora.
We are going to be taking communion.
Vamos a tomar la comunión.
The blood and the body of Christ.
El cuerpo y la sangre de Jesús.
The representation.
En representación.
It is not the blood and the body of Christ.
No es la sangre ni es el cuerpo.
But as some religions believe.
Como algunas religiones creen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh,
silent.
Turn it on.
Glory to your name, Lord. Hallelujah.
Okay, so. It's not the blood and the body of Christ. It's the representation of the blood and the body of Christ.
Yes.
Okay. That's important that you know that.
Check, check.
It's important that you know that because there's some religions that believe it's the actual blood.
Es muy importante que nosotros sepamos porque hay algunas religiones que creen que en realidad el vino es la sangre de Jesús.
Right. So if you see some particular people trying to haul me off to crucify me somewhere for what I just said. Just know God's word is God's word.
Yeah, la palabra de Dios es la palabra.
So before I have you come up and get the blood,
antes que usted venga
and the body,
a tomar el cuerpo y la sangre,
sacraments,
como un sacramento,
I have to give you a warning.
Yo tengo que darle una advertencia.
You ready? Here's a warning.
¿Está listo? Mire, aquí está la advertencia.
If you open your word real quick.
Si usted abre la palabra rápidamente.
1 Corinthians 11.
En Primera de Corintios 11.
Yes, yes.
Unworthy. And we're going to go to verse 27.
11:27.
This is important that you understand.
Es muy importante que entendamos esto.
So it says, wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the blood and the body of the Lord.
That's right.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. 11:27. De manera que cualquiera que comiere este pan o bebiere esta copa del Señor indignamente será culpado del cuerpo y de la sangre del Señor.
But let a man examine himself.
Por tanto, pruébese cada uno a sí mismo.
Means man or woman.
Significa sea hombre o sea mujer.
And so let him or her
que coma así
eat of that bread
el pan
and drink of that cup.
Y beba de la copa.
For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily,
porque el que come y bebe indignamente,
eateth and drinketh,
sin discernir,
damnation to himself.
El cuerpo de Cristo, juicio, come y bebe.
Not discerning the Lord's body. Amen.
Sin discernir el cuerpo de Jesús.
For this cause,
por lo cual,
many are weak,
muchos enfermos,
and sickly among you,
y debilitados entre vosotros.
And many sleep.
Y muchos ya duermen.
That's not the sleep that you're going to go home to tonight.
Y no hablo de dormir como vamos a ir a dormir esta noche.
That means death.
Esto significa los que están muertos.
God is serious.
Dios es muy serio.
He is serious.
Él es serio.
About the sacrifice his son did for.
Acerca de su hijo el sacrificio que él hizo.
So this morning.
So en esta hora.
Before we take of the elements.
Antes que tomemos estos elementos.
I'm going to have us all pause.
Y voy a pedirles que tengamos una pausa.
And it's a good time.
Y es un buen momento.
To admit any sin that you're not aware of.
Para hacerte responsable de cualquier pecado.
Or you are aware of.
O de cualquier pecado que sepas o del que no sepas.
To the Lord.
Y presentárselo a Dios.
And ask forgiveness.
Y pedirle a Él que nos perdone.
Before we take the elements.
Antes de que tomemos los elementos.
So that way.
De esa manera.
You're taking.
Digno.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay, so let's go ahead and just take just a minute. Just close our eyes.
Vamos a cerrar sus ojos y tome un momento.
Let's focus on our Heavenly Father.
Y enfoquémonos en nuestro Padre.
And let's just surrender everything to Him and ask forgiveness.
Y presentemos todo delante de Él y pidámosle perdón.
Aleluya.
Forgive us, Lord Jesus. We are guilty, Lord Jesus. You know, Lord. Tú sabes todo. Nada se esconde de ti, Señor. You know everything about us, Lord. Forgive us, Lord Jesus. En el nombre de Jesús. Perdónanos, Señor. Sí, Señor, te amamos. Gracias por el sacrificio. Por la redención de nuestros pecados. Padre, haznos dignos de recordar ese sacrificio. En el nombre.
Amén. So I ask that you come up now. Let's go ahead and get the elements.
Le voy a pedir que pase de frente y por favor tome los elementos.
Gloria, aleluya.
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 Sí, Señor. Bendito Dios, Señor. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Te adoramos, Señor. Te adoramos. Te bendecimos. Gracias por morir por nosotros. Thank you for dying on our behalf, Lord Jesus. Thank you. Loving us so much, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord God, for your patience. You, hallelujah, your love. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Gracias, Jesús. Eres digno, Señor, de ser adorado, Padre, de ser exaltado. You're worthy to be praised, Lord God. You are worthy, Father God. To receive the honor, to receive grace, hallelujah, to receive the glory, the honor, and praise of Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, te adoramos, te adoramos. We bless your name, Lord God. Bendecimos tu nombre. We bless your name, Lord God. Thank you for loving us, for giving us a hope, Lord Jesus, giving us life, hallelujah. Thank you for all the things you've done for us. Hallelujah. Gracias, Dios. Gracias.
Hallelujah. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Mighty God. mighty God. Yeah, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Precious Jesus.
Hermano Pedro, me le pedí llevar a Zaina. Y después viene y agarra el suyo, por favor.
Thank you, Lord.
¿Y qué te fue a calentar la comida? Si just went and put the food waiting. Brother Pedro is going to take it. And he'll come back for gifts. Okay. Yeah. We'll wait for you, Brother Pedro.
Precious Jesus.
Well, as we're waiting,
a medida que esperamos,
so your mind and your heart this morning.
Que su mente y su corazón.
This is a very important time.
Este es un momento muy importante.
Where God himself,
donde Dios mismo,
is going to judge us one day.
Dios un día nos va a juzgar.
He is the one that makes us worthy this
y Él quiere que seamos dignos en esta hora.
So let's not hold any kind of grudge.
So no guardemos ningún resentimiento.
Any kind of sin.
Ningún pecado.
Lay that at his feet.
Traigámoslo a los pies de Jesús.
When we get done with communion this morning,
y cuando terminemos esta ceremonia de comunión,
you should be brand new.
Vamos a ser nuevos.
Amén.
Sí, Señor. Gracias, Dios. Thank you, Jesus. Gracias, Señor, te damos, Padre, por dar tu vida por nosotros. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Worship to be praised.
Thank you, God.
Hallelujah. Worship of the honor. Praise Jesus. We honor the name of God. Give us the strength. Jesus, thank you. Gracias.
Hallelujah.
Señor.
For God's word says.
Porque la palabra de Dios dice.
For as I have received.
Porque yo he recibido.
Of the Lord.
Del Señor.
That which also I delivered unto you.
Eso que les he pasado a ustedes.
That the Lord Jesus.
Que el Señor Jesús.
The same night in which he was betrayed.
La misma noche el que fue tomado.
Took bread.
Él tomó el pan.
And when he had given thanks.
Y después de haber dado gracias.
He broke it.
Él lo partió.
And said.
Y dijo.
Take eat.
Tómenlo.
This is my body.
Porque este es mi cuerpo.
Which is broken for you.
Porque será quebrantado por ustedes.
Do.
Háganlo.
In remembrance of me.
En memoria de mí.
Toma
el pan.
Thank you.
Señor, gracias, Padre. Bendito sea tu nombre, Dios. Sea tu nombre exaltado, Señor. Aleluya. Gracias, Dios.
After the same manner.
Y de la misma forma.
Also he took the cup.
También tomó el vino.
When he had supped.
Y después de haberlo.
Say.
Dijo.
This cup,
esta copa,
is the New Testament,
es el nuevo pacto,
in my blood,
en mi sangre.
This do ye,
cada vez que lo tomen,
as often as ye drink,
y cada vez que ustedes lo tomen,
in remembrance,
háganlo como memoria,
of me,
de mí.
Drink in remembrance of
me. Tome el vino recordando el sacrificio.
Thank you, Jesus.
Gracias, Jesús.
Thank you for that sacrifice.
Gracias te damos por ese sacrificio.
We will always remember.
Y siempre vamos a recordar. En el nombre de Jesús.
I'm going to turn the service back over to Pastor.
Hallelujah.
Okay. Well, we're good with time, so I appreciate you being here today. Le agradezco por haber estado juntos, ¿verdad? En este tiempo que hemos tenido con el Señor.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Okay, so please don't go home. We have food, and I think after having received the word of God in our spiritual stomachs, so yeah, you can be seated for a moment.
Praise Jesus.
I just have one announcement. Solamente tengo un anuncio para ustedes. Y Dios es bueno. Thank you, Reverend Mel, for leading us on the communion. That's good that once in a while we remember what Jesus did on the cross for us. So de vez en cuando es bueno recordar lo que Dios hizo por nosotros. Por eso somos libres, ¿verdad? Libres de la condenación eterna. We have been set free from condemnation. So we have eternal life because of Jesus. Even if we die in the flesh, that's unstoppable. Eso no se puede parar, hermanos, que un día en esta carne tengamos que morir. Si el Señor no ha venido. If the Lord has not returned, we're not going to. I mean, if the Lord comes before we die, we don't have to go to the ground.
No.
But even then, with this flesh, we cannot go to heaven.
Mm-hmm.
Because dust will go to dust.
Yeah, thank you, Jesus.
And our spirit and our soul
will
go with Jesus.
Yes.
So, hermano, es buena noticia, la mejor noticia.
Aleluya.
Porque el morir es inevitable. Pero posible, estaba diciendo que si no morimos para ir a estar en la tierra porque somos polvo y al polvo volveremos. Si el Señor viene y estamos vivos, nos vamos con Él, pero este cuerpo no puede entrar al reino de los cielos. Es lo que es polvo, regresará al polvo. Pero el alma y el espíritu se va con Dios y es el que vive para siempre. Great news. So let's go home, like my wife said. Let's be encouraged. Vámonos animados. Because when we are discouraged, it's not a good thing. Cuando estamos desanimados, no es bueno. Mi consejo de final de este año para usted, my advice for you, because we'll be leaving, me and my wife, and Brother Renato will be leaving too, for the rest of the year. Vamos a salir de acá por el resto del año. But I know that you're not here because of me.
No.
So I don't have to be concerned. Hey, even if I leave, you need to congregate.
Yeah,
I cannot say that because and then I will be saying, no, you're coming because me.
Yes.
It's not about me. Yes. It's about Jesus. Yes. The Word of God is here. The Word of God has been preached here.
Yes.
Le decía que si yo le digo, oh, hermanos, yo tengo que salir, pero el hecho que me vaya no significa que ustedes no van a venir. Era porque entonces estaría diciendo, ustedes vienen porque yo estoy aquí. Y aquí el más importante es Dios. The most important that we have here is God, the Holy Spirit, and a great word to start with, encourage. So, mi hermano, mi palabra es un regalo para usted. This word is a gift for me.
Yes, hallelujah.
Because I have received that by grace. Lo que he recibido por gracia es la palabra y las promesas. What we have received from God is words and promises that will become true. Promesas son palabras que se van a hacer realidad un día. Pero mi consejo es este. My own advice to you as a person, as your leader, whatever you think I am for you, do not be discouraged. Discouragement is bad. So, hermano, no se me desanime. No se desanime por nada.
For nothing, that's right.
Por nada.
Nothing.
¿Qué es lo contrario de estar desanimado? Estar animado, ¿verdad? Fácil, como dijo Zayda. Obedecer. So, like Zayda said, what is it that we need to be obedient? Just to obey. There's no other way around. Just be obedient. Y la forma de estar animado es de estar animado. It's a decision. Because there are reasons that we all can be discouraged. There are reasons where we can be discouraged just to know that one day we may die. Con solo de saber de que un día vamos a morir, nos podíamos todos aquí lamentar. So let's do something. Maybe next year when I come, we'll set one day where we all can be discouraged just in one day.
Thank you, Jesus.
And complain on that one day.
Yeah.
And do whatever, just that one day. But not every day. Okay? Entonces, sí, de forma así, ¿verdad? Cuando regrese, ponemos un día y ahí nos montamos a llorar y a quejarnos de todo. Pero solo un día, no todos los días. Okay? So, ore por nosotros, por favor. Si el Señor no viene antes que regresemos, nos miramos allá en aquel lugar que tenemos en común. If the Lord,
thank you, Lord.
Has not returned, If he has returned before I come back from our vacation, we will be in the air, right? And we will be Jesus with Jesus forever. Amen? So let's stand up. So please be encouraged.
Amen.
Just let him encourage one another, like the Bible said. Así como. Sí, sí, muy importante. El brother Renato. Hermano Renato también.
I'll stand up there and the camera will pick everybody up.
Sí. Ah, okay. They want to have the picture of everyone.
With everybody. You know, if you would come forth.
If, venga, por favor, aquí enfrente. Por favor.
Yes, Pastora Saida is coming.
Come gracias por su
and come forward.
Just come forward. We just done.
And stand with your pastor. Come stand with our pastor. We did this before. It's a beautiful occasion. Come on, you. Come, come on. We all stand together. You can hide in the back.
You take picture.
For a moment. Oh, allá arriba mejor. Para que.
Who is missing?
Sí, sí. Puede traer otras personas.
No más miro a mi esposa.
You can rest your mind. Me canta tu sonrisa, mi otra vez. Porque te va a cantar. Who said to say that?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Glory to God.
Ready? You get us on three. Smile.
Jesus. Hallelujah.
Okay, it took three. And now I'll take one. We're just ready. Get set.
Hallelujah.
Okay. We'll do it. Thank you. Okay.